Hello, my name is Cristina Hodgson. I graduated from Loughborough University with a degree in PE and sports science in 1997. So, 20 years ago now? My goodness. Oh, you're a pretty little baby then. Anyway, it's amazing how time flies. So, thank you for sending me some questions in regards to my publication experience. My debut novel, A Little of Chantal Rose, will be released this coming 4th of May. And you sent me some questions to answer in regards to this publication experience. So thank you, and here we go. Question number one. Can you give any advice to students looking to publish their own text? Okay, well, the first step, and what any publisher or agent will advise of you, is to polish your opening chapters as much as possible, because these are the chapters that they're going to request of you. Some might ask for the whole manuscript, but they'll only really look at the first chapters anyway. So if you have someone of your confidence that you can send this work to, and try and tidy it up a little bit more, then that's great, because this is, you've got one chance of making a good impression, so you've got to make the most of it. Okay, so once you've tidied up your work, you've got to search through and select a number of agents or publishers to send your work off to. There's hundreds out there, so look through them carefully, choose those who work with your genre, because you really don't want to send off your erotica novel to a publisher who only works and publishes children's short stories. I mean, it just won't go down well at all. So, don't waste your time, don't waste their time. Just go through the list and choose those appropriate to you. And then you'll have to write out a brief query letter, and make it brief, just relevant to your work. Most publishers' agents will be receiving, 40 plus manuscripts per day. I've never been a whiz at mathematics, but 40 times 5, you work on a 5-day week, 40 times 5, it's like 200 plus manuscripts per week, every week. If you just write in your, introduction of your query letter to whom it may concern, you have a good chance they're not going to read any further. So, try and find out who's in charge of submissions. Send it direct to them. Put their name on dear whoever, but make sure it's their name. Get it right. Because, like I say, who puts you whom it may concern, they're just probably not going to bother reading any further. They have so much to read on a daily basis. They'll be dedicating perhaps top 5 minutes to look at your email. So you want to make it sort of stand out. Make them know that you're keen and that you've done your research on their company and that you want to work with them. Also a little line perhaps on how you came across their company. They'll probably appreciate that too. So you want to do a bit of research in this. Like I say, 20 plus manuscripts per week. These facts and figures aren't meant to demoralise your hope of finding a publisher or an agent, but they are, to help you keep your feet on the floor and prepare you for the rejection letters that will probably come. I mean, I think every author has received at some point in some form a rejection letter. So, be ready for them. They will come, but it's okay. It's okay. Most of us have received them. A lot of the time it's because of that. They have so many manuscripts to go through. They just don't have time. So, it's okay. And like they say, you'll get there in the end. If you keep going, you'll get there in the end. There's a lovely quote by Richard Bach who says, a professional writer is an amateur who never gave up. So that would also be my advice to you guys, okay? Don't give up. Question number two. How important are environmental changes in being able to publish your own book? Move towards e-text, internet, etc. Okay, when I was fully aware that if it hadn't been for this move, my novel would probably not have got published. The upfront cost of producing an ebook is minimum, which has in turn led to the growth of various small independent publishers more willing to give authors like me this golden opportunity. So thankfully, you know, ebooks have emerged, because I probably wouldn't be sitting here if it wasn't for that. Also, ebooks, you can actually now self-publish as well, which is a lovely option if you like. It's actually becoming quite popular now. In my own case, I felt I needed the backing of somebody who knew what they were doing, somebody who could offer me advice, guide me in the right direction. I needed a publisher behind me to do this. I also actually thought that, well, if somebody outside my family circle was willing enough to give me a chance, willing enough to spend time on me, spend money on me, then my work could be that bad. So that was a bit more why I pursued looking for a publisher. Anyway, question number 3. What challenges have you faced along the way? Okay, well, loads, to be honest. Not so much perhaps the actual writing, though, to be honest. That came a bit more naturally. You know, they go on about the writer's block, which is pretty much when all your imaginary friends stop talking to you. Luckily, mine are quite chatty, so at the moment I'm okay there. But what I really did struggle with was finding a publisher. My text was originally wrote it 13 years ago. 13 years ago, ebooks weren't really sort of in the market. You know, you have to go to the big 4 publishing houses, and to get into them, you'd have to go through an agent. So I selected various agents to send my work off to. I couldn't email them. I had to actually physically send, you know, physical papers, you know, printed off chapters of my book. So the postal cost was actually quite high. I was living and still live in Spain, and I was sending it off to agents who live in the UK. So I was having to send off, you know, a lot of work off to the UK. So I carefully selected several agents. I naively believed that I would get chosen straight away. I was just like, oh yes, I'll get chosen straight away, and I wasn't. I was rejected by all of them. I think I just wasn't aware of how difficult it is to get into this world. I wasn't aware, and so obviously the rejection letters, when they came, it was a real letdown. I was so disheartened. I have to say, though, some of the rejection letters I received were very, very nice. I did get some very, very nice replies, but they were rejections all the same. So I was very let down, and I pushed from my head all thoughts of getting my work published. And my manuscript sat in the corner for over 10 years, collecting dust. Until one day, my dad, who'd read the original manuscript, and loved it, but obviously, as only dads can, encouraged me to update it and send it off again. So I did. But this time I now found myself, you know, in a full-time job with 2 young children to look after, and it took me, I think, over a year and a half to update it and re-edit and update it, and I sent it off. About this time last year, I sent it off again to some straight to publishers who accepted non-solicited manuscripts, and I got my lucky chance. So at the end of the day, don't give up, because you know this is what's happened to me. It took me 13 years, and if I can do it, honestly, anyone can. So don't give up. That's my motto. Don't give up. And sometimes, actually, to be honest, it's taken me longer to find a publisher than it did to write the actual work, my actual manuscript. So I actually sometimes didn't all wonder if I jumped the whole thing up. But thankfully, I haven't. It's real. So there you go. And okay, the final question. Have the challenges been worth it? Okay, well, you're all Loughborough students. You probably all come from some sort of sporting background. So you know what it's like to get up early and go for an early morning running session or an early morning swim session. You know, hours and hours of training. You know, when you win a match, when you win a race, is it worth it? Again, you're at Loughborough. You're at the best sports university in the world. What challenges did you face to get in? Were they worth it? I think we all know the questions of this one. Of course they were. Any outcome that is positive, doesn't matter how hard the journey has been, it makes it all worth it. In fact, sometimes when the challenges, you know, that you come across, the harder they are, the more satisfying the end result is. So definitely, has it been worth it? Of course it has. Definitely. And I think it's important to have dreams and to try and fulfil them. You do need to work hard. If it was easy, everyone would be an Olympian. If it was easy, everyone would be a published writer. But if you work hard and you're consistent and you're focused, you can achieve almost anything. So definitely, I mean, you have to be positive in what you're doing and believe in yourself and believe in your work, and you'll get there in the end, honestly. You will. Just don't give up. I would also like to add here, you know, people might think, oh, I bet she was an A-grade student, or I bet this all came naturally to her. And I'd like to add that I was just, you know, an average student. I struggled with exams, I struggled with assignments, I would get really nervous as well before my exams. But I worked hard. I worked hard and I was consistent, again, with my sporting achievements as well. It was all down to hard work, you know? And I think that's the key. You don't worry if you don't get A's and everything. As long as you're doing your hardest, you'll come out with a positive end result. So I just want to say that, you know, I wasn't an A-grade student, I was very average. But, you know, dreams can happen. So I'd like to thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk about my work, talk a little bit about me. Like I say, if you ever think that you need to contact me and I can perhaps give you more tips on how to get a publisher or anything in regards to, you know, writing or anything really that you think I can help you with, feel free to send me an email. I would be so happy to try and help. So my email is hello@cristinahodgson.com. You can actually find me on Twitter as well, Hodgson Cristina, or my webpage, which is www.cristinahodgson.com. So feel free to contact me. I'd be more than willing to try and help out. Also, if you're on Facebook, which I'm sure you guys all are, I'm having a Facebook launch event on the 4th of May. So look me up on Facebook if you can. Click on the event. Come and join in the fun. I'll be giving out lots of freebies, like this mug. I've got key rings, I've got bookmarkers, a little bit of wine as well, a little bit of wine. Anyway, come along, it'd be lovely to see you there. I'd love to hear from you. I also would love to hear, you know, if you get your work published and stuff like that, let me know, it'd be brilliant to hear your story as well. So thank you again, and I look forward to seeing you. Bye-bye.